A Chinese hospital ship deployed near Escoda Shoal in the West Philippine Sea, where a Philippine Coast Guard vessel is stationed. According to PCG spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea, Commodore J. Tariela, there are also 24 Chinese maritime militia vessels and one CCG ship near Escoda Shoal. He notes China often deploys several ships over fears the BRP Teresa Magbanua will stay in Escoda Shoal for good. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department urges Filipino seafarers to avoid the Red Sea unless absolutely necessary. The DFA says the situation in the waterway has worsened and it poses a clear and present danger to Filipinos plying the route. It calls on seafarers to exercise their right to refuse sailing. This comes after a Greek flagship with a Filipino crew was hit by a Houthi missile. The Migrant Workers Department says all 23 Filipinos are safe and are now en route to a safe port. The DMW is now working on their immediate repatriation.
The Philippine Immigration Bureau allegedly already knew dismissed Mayor Alice Go had left the country prior to Senator Risa Ontiveros' announcement. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian says he was informed that several government agencies had been validating leads that Go had fled as early as July. He wants immigration authorities to explain why they did not divulge the information to the Senate, which is conducting hearings concerning Go. Gatchalian adds the accountability of the concerned agencies will be the focus of a hearing scheduled for next week.
Even us, hindi kami binigyan ng briefing. Diba? Kung in confidence yan, sana humingi ng executive session at binrief muna tayo kung naka-alis na o ano. Ngayon, nagiging suspicious tuloy ako, no? Personally, dahil bakit tinago pa sa amin at tinago sa publiko? Parang gusto siya ata itago yung naging problema na nakalusot yung tao, si Go Huapin.
Philippine investigators are still trying to determine how the fugitive Bamban Mayor and her companions were able to sneak out of the country. The Criminal Investigation and Detection Group suspects Go's group made use of the country's porous borders and fled by sea. CIDG Chief Police Major General Leo Francisco says there is a need to review processes for those leaving the country.
I-reviewin natin siguro yung ating mga procedures sa paglalabas sa bansa. Next, titingnan talaga natin yung napakalawak na coastline natin. Mahihirapan tayong magbantay dito. Alam nyo, kung titingnan natin yung coastline natin, talagang mahirap bantayan. So yan yung mga bagay siguro na kailangan nating i-review, pagtuunan ng pansin para hindi na mangyari yung ganitong mga bagay na nakakalabas ng bansa na hindi nalalaman ng mga otoridad na kagaya namin.
In sports, Philippine boxer Ira Villegas gets more rewards after her bronze Olympic finish. She received on Friday in her hometown Tacloban, Leyte, a 6 million peso house and lot, as well as a brand new car. The lavish gifts are from Leyte representatives, House Speaker Martin Romualdez and his wife, Congresswoman Yeda. The prizes were given during a tribute party and a hero's welcome for the Filipino Olympian. Filipino tennis sensation Alex Ayala misses the U.S. Open main draw after a tough loss to Romanian Elena Gabriela Rusi. Ayala clinched the first set 6-3, but Rusi dominated the second and third sets, cutting short Ayala's ambitious U.S. Open campaign. The 19-year-old Filipino entered the qualifiers, ranked 148 in the world. She is likely to rise in the rankings after coming one win away from qualifying.